Good morning. I don't do online dating, and I'm sad to hear that Susan Windram at the Southern Reporter has been chased out of office.
Like
she's now doing a ladies' magazine.
100% British and Irish food in all our burgers, including our cheeseburger. Just 90.
You remember Susan Windram? Yeah, that's the hamburger joke. The joke about the penis in the Roman Empire when they were sieging the country being cut off by the soldiers surrounding that castle and being basted into bread and then cast over the castle walls. Yeah, the loaves and fucking fishes joke. Yeah, I'm looking for the perfect woman. Yeah, and I've been playing that series of musical things that you've just seen, and this is Robbie Williams singing about the Formula One fraud sector and how there are very few perfect women to choose from.
And be from the same menu.
This is Bernie Eccleston's sector. Yeah, Jackie Stewart, the Scottish hero. Then I played this. I want you to understand every little bit of it.
A man of many talents.
Hey, great fish!
This is a movie about massive pan-continental fraud and about the false religion at the same time. Otto is the Ottoman Empire and the PISO family member who wrote all of the bullshit in the Christian Bible and then wrote all of the bullshit in the Quran within the first 140 years of the period when Jesus was never born. And all of the PISO menagerie are in all of the jokes through all of world history. That is the Walt Disney joke about the biggest Zionist output, and that is the icon that they use in the witchy movie about the queen that his lover raises her from the dead with a kiss beyond the grave. It's the Snow White myths, okay? And we know why his name is in all of the stories. Marks and Spencer's were in this week's stories about the intel transition, yeah, of the leaders of our world into the vice chancellor sector at the universities. That's Miss Manningham Buller, and then selling all of your integrity so that the world can be sold into a lawless cabal. Yeah, and the metro is hell in Paris, as you now understand, and the World Trade Commission leaders are Prince Andrew, who blows up the trade building so that we can continue with World War III and the demonization of Islam, where world leaders are doing all of the sinning in the terror sector, yeah, and in the planning the next war, yeah. the life of Brian is the joke about the B-ARIAN. Yeah, the B-ARIAN. The Ryan's daughter joke about infidelity in the bedroom and people who have lost their limbs in war for the corrupted kings and queens is about the bee ovary for the woman in Ireland who's prepared to loose her morals and open up her thighs to the war victim of the monarchy that run Ireland and live in Hillsborough Castle. Yeah, and the Fish Called Wanda trailer is even more vicious because Archie Leech is also Archelaus, the joke about the fire pans delousing the Jews before you kill them en masse. That's the Schindler film. I have Schindler's director numbers like all of the people that run the Scottish Borders Council. They don't register their interests in the borders for reputational reasons. Instead, they're in the Arab Dubai Chamber of Commerce. Yeah, the Arab British Chamber of Commerce registered in Dubai like Michael Ellis Moore with the Assassination Bureau in Glasgow, that is Crawl, yeah, who's disappeared from our politics so he can kill from the back room, yeah, by the like the people at Holyrood and Hollywood. Sorry, slip of the tongue. Yeah, the Fish Called Wanda joke is that there's an infidelitous woman who's prepared to sell her body, and that is a woman who's now a baroness, Haden Guest. Haden is hell, part of the joke, okay? And what you've got is the Canadian linkage, because she is Canadian and gets to be in the House of Lords, yeah? Like the baron that is the press magnate who has actually been prosecuted. That is Baron Black, yeah? The fascist colour, okay? And he has been convicted of heinous crimes in telling lies to the world's people because he's the boss in the Canadian I'm a lumberjack doing okay thing, and he gets to be in the highest ranking geopolitical organisation with the Bromsteins from Canada, yeah, who are actually the bootleggers, yeah, in the period where we were not allowed to drink on a Sunday and you had to travel to a distant pub to be able to do that, all of it entirely for profit, which is why I'm going to show you what the Borders Council has become next door in a few minutes. I want you to understand every aspect of the Anglo-Hollywood Canadian linkage that is the Fish Called Wanda movie, because it takes you into the Vatican money trail all of the time, and that is the money trail launched by the PISO family, yeah, and then followed up by the money lenders that Jesus warned us about. That's Mayor Rothschild and the five arrows that fly out of Selkirk. And Kevin Drummond is also resigned. Look at the video I made on the Southern Reporter, Miss Susan Windram, Kevin Drummond, and all of the cabal of false news people that are Ashley Highfield's empire at Johnston Press, which I'm highlighting in the video. Watch this carefully. I'll stop it every time there's a joke about the world's 2,000-year-old biggest crime that is religion. It's obvious to the simple man when you dissect the complicated clues. Yeah, and the Borders Council is so corrupted now that it cannot account for itself, which is why everything it does and all of the scams of the assets that have been stripped by Alistair Hutton and his wife from our region, yeah, are now in the globalised fraud, and no one in the Borders is accountable for it. But Councillor Mitchell, my old friend, yeah, who's not a Freemason but his dad was, is allowed to talk to David Cameron, yeah, about how they're going to manage the situation, about the world's most insightful man being able to talk openly to the world. Yeah, So Otto is the Ottoman fucking empire, and he's able to put knives in everybody's back because the Ottoman Empire used to be Christianity, led by the Holy Roman Emperor, out of fucking Naples, yeah, with a gun to everybody's head, because Naples is where the Christian Bible was defrauded. And in the article next door about the Borders Council, I will transit into Naples and show you just when it erupted. Yeah, it erupted when writing was invented in Canaan. Yeah, and the Bible and the ancient papyri could be written by fraudsters like her, who's prepared to sell her body to destroy the countries that she lives in. Baroness Haden Guest. Yeah, no longer a prominent figure in British politics, because she's fucked off to the Havens, like all of the members of this cast. That's John Cleese. Yeah, the Basel Fawlty Bank of Switzerland, that is the Bank of International Settlements joke. She's wearing the pussy colours, and she is just a prostitute for the globalised fraud, which is why they put her into the House of Lords, right next to Lord Sanderson of Bowden and the thieves that run the cabinet, and for decade after decade. And they've got a sleazy little cockney, yeah, who's relatively anonymous. That's the cock neighing joke, yeah, about the slaves who are entirely able to appoint the next king of the slaves, yet the puppet's on a string. And that is the really, really sick Pinocchio donkey jokes and the monkey's tail, yet that every one of the public school boys that become the politicians, yet unless you're far enough up the food chain of the biblical fraud or the newspaper's fraud, you will not be protected from being in a uniform in the great wars that they engineer. Right then, so that's just the first photo. Yeah, and this one is Kevin Clooney. Yeah, the Clooney Abbey in France. Yeah, Max, my mate in France, yeah, that lives in the commune, is the only one in the last few days to send me a message. Yeah, he lives in the commune in France and spends his whole life writing about the menace of the clouds in the sky and the chemtrails that are going to kill the Duke of Edinburgh and me and you all at the same time, because the leaders of our world are really stupid enough to launch ecological scams like that. My mate Max in the commune does not say a word about Madame Lagarde, yeah, the prostitute from the IMF that has dismembered every innocent country since Strauss-Kahn, the rapist at the IMF, gave up the ghost because he created an earthquake when he was tried for rape in New York, where they don't even have a fault line. Right then.
He's a man of many talents.
Angry.
So Kevin Clooney, yeah, the seal, yeah, and the seal that is the seal school, yeah, and the jokes about religion and the seals for the bishopric. Yeah, that is the man in yesterday's movie that sells our country into, yeah, having the stammering king being the only person that's allowed to represent us and to make the vital speeches, not about integration with our colleagues all over the Europe, but the need to kill them because of the deviancy and the illegitimacy of the British monarchy. Okay, yeah, it is really sad. And the Birmingham bloke that plays Winston Churchill in that has horrible cancers as well. Yeah, that's the one that makes the jokes in the movies about London and the Cockneys. Yeah, and he's in the Auf Wiedersehen cast. That's Barry from Auf Wiedersehen, plays Winston Churchill in that vicious, vicious joke about World War II. Okay? Yeah, and I forget where his cancer was. It was really, really serious. Yeah. And there's the GNO Royal Mail people passing by. Everyone in our country is paid to be part of the intel operation. Yeah, since Turin and taxis manipulated the release of the news all over Europe, and they were the yellow taxi firm and the Python carriages that are the predecessors to the Python jokes about the crashing of the news and the honesty of our world. Yeah. Right then, sorry, I'm not getting very far into the Wanda thing. Do you see the Wendy joke is the woman who's prepared to be loose with her morals and to swap the partners, even the genders of them? Yeah, that is the Peter Pan, the god of love joke. Yeah, and Wendy.
Fish! Oh, a little squeeze of lemon, some tartar sauce.
Ken is a man of few words.
Tell him from me.
So, the Monty Pythons. Yeah, all of them think it's really, really funny yet to dismember your country. And there is the fucking goldfish that is the Rothschild family's penis that gets up Queen Victoria's illegitimate vagina in the bigamous marriage that she has with Prince Albert the Poofta. Let me take you now to Wikipedia and I'll show you a Prince Albert chain. Yeah, it's on my website. I'm going to show you that we're not allowed to do anything that is immoral, yeah, to our children. But if you let your children play with Wikipedia or the sky buttons, you can let them see prostitutes working in the sleaze sector on everyday Sky Network broadcasting. The sun's come out. I don't know whether or not it gets excited by Prince Albert's sexual apparatus, but Queen Victoria was not allowed to be exposed to that because the Rothschilds were abusing her all of the time. Right then, so Prince Albert's chain, Wikipedia. If you cannot find it there, go to my website and search for it. It will bring tears to your eyes, like the joke that Michael Gambon shares about telling lies in every interview he makes to Jeremy Clarkson, the propagandist from Chipping Norton, who tells lies in every interview he makes and laughs at the Formula One sector joke. Right then. Prince Albert genital piercing Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia run by a friend called Jimmy Wales, of all of the contracts that the people get in the tax havens. That's Jimmy Wales, who has now defected to Necker with Richard Branson, and he gets to party with all of the elites, including Tony Blair. Prince Albert was killed by the monarchy because he's no longer needed to be part of the breeding chamber, and he becomes the much neglected, there's the penis with the pin through the circumcised portion, the Jewish joke. Yet there is no division between the religious profiteers, but this is sick. Okay, he cannot have sex. Yeah, Prince Albert genital piercing. Yeah, that shows you the piercing. Yeah, and the chain gets connected to that little aperture, so it cannot get connected to the vagina of the Empress, who is the Empress upon which the sun is about to set really, really soon. Yeah, because all of them dedicate their lives to brutalizing the whole world for personal gain. Yeah, and to run the illegitimate monarchy for 160 illegitimate years. That was up to 2012. That makes it 163 illegitimate years now, and all of it is a murderous, genocidal period, with both of those great wars fought in the name of freedom by the German bastards that happened to be in the British monarchy. Yeah, and the only decent one of them must have been George III, because they banged him up in a straitjacket. Let me see if the chain is portrayed below. I'm sorry that some of your children might be exposed to this, but they can watch the prostitutes dancing around. On Putlocker, watch the King's speech on Putlocker and see how nauseating it is. Yet that what our monarchy are dedicated to is being an advertising vent for that empire which they brutalise all of the fucking time. Yeah, and that's all he's worried about. A 1.5-inch gauge Prince Albert. Yeah, sorry about that. In the earlier versions of this, it was just the chain, and they have not got the chain. You're going to have to look it up on my website, because all of this is really, really sensitive. Yeah? Right then. And so, let's get back to the fish called Wanda. I'll shut that down for lack of space. Yeah, so we can expose the financial crimes of Johnson Press and the lords and ladies that fucking run it. As usual, the first subsidiary is in Ireland, the sectarian place where all of these religious and monarchy jokes, yeah, that become the ambulance disaster at Hillsborough, yeah, when the sectarian violence right through World War II and that Madam B. Overy joke was being made about the manipulation of minds by our corrupted medias. Right then, so bye bye Prince Albert's chain. They've already taken the chain off. Right then, fish called Wanda, Wendy. Yeah, that's not personal. I know some Wendy's. Yeah, and I know that all of them are part of the monitoring team. That Wendy used to go to the church for a time. When all of them realise that the acts of God are real, yeah, they panic a little bit. And they get God-fearing. But they're really decent people at the bottom of it, led by the vicious peer pressure, which is why we now have a Canadian out of her place yeah, running the Bank of England. And that is the I'm a lumberjack doing okay joke for the Pythons team that he's from. And all of it, the B-ARIAN joke, the life of Brian, is really vicious. That's the B-ARIANs that wrote the Christian Bible. Arius Calpurnius PISO.
George is the man with the black 13.
So, the dimwit Cockney, like the St. Trinians. Yeah. Yeah, the ninny, knee, Arian joke. Yeah, about the children with the hockey sticks. Yeah, and all of it takes you into Queensbury, and that is the Harry Potter with the hockey sticks joke, and all of the characters in that are parodies of the whole of the religious joke that just keeps being replayed by Zionist Hollywood. Does not matter about the label, it does matter about where the greenbacks come from that get into your suitcase, which is an intimate part of this film. Sorry, Borders Council, I'm neglecting your frauds.
Millions, my friends, and wonder.
Do you speak Italian?
Molto, very curioso. Is the woman they love. They all set out to commit the perfect crime.
Yeah, the woman they love. The lady they love. The baroness they love. Yeah, as long as you're getting the dosh, then you get that fanny opened up. Yeah, it is as simple as that. No one is prepared to take on the cause that is the protection of the world's children, but no one. Which is why I tried again. I played the song, the little story I made about the Duchess of Roxburgh who was forced into divorce proceedings for no particular reason. She's not allowed to visit her children now. She is, though, the sister of the Duke of Westminster and Britain's richest families, yeah, and that takes you into Imran Khan's missus and all of the manipulation of all of the bloodlines and all of the intermarriages between Catholics and Protestants, even in little towns like this, which involves the Quislings from the Better Off Together movement, and Miss at the Southern Reporter, I forget her name, the editor was Susan Windram. She works for the Prince's Trust. When I expose that graphically, my video only gets 170 visits, but she resigns along with Kev Drummond, who are revealed as sinners and major criminals in the asset stripping of the law courts in our region, the false news that they project about the innocence of Johnston Press, which is just to get rid of jobs in our region, and the print runs that still are able sometimes to tell the truth. We have a sex criminal in our town now since the new man took over. I forget what his name is, but I would feel obligated to tell you that I will be looking into more about what he does. He's in Alan Beath's constituency. That's Alan Beath that claimed £100,000 a year to drive up and down the A1 to the House of Lords. Yeah, head of the Lib Dems, for a Lib Dem minor character. Yeah, they've had huge numbers of resignations because they have lost the respect. Yeah, none of them are innocent people. David Steele, that I met at the 3-day event where I made the little video about the woman that was the former Duchess there, yeah, married into that bloodline so that the wealth of the richest family could be shared with the Rothschilds and the Duke's relatives. And then they get the new one in who they pretend is from America, and then it comes out that she's a Wynne Williams. Yeah, and they become massive law firms. Yeah, because Archie Leech in this movie about the fraud and the defrauding of our country that is the United Kingdom, that used to be called Great Britain for a laugh, and in its anthem it sings about knavish tricks, yeah, and suppressing its enemies all around the world. That is why the empire was created, by sleaze and violence. Sorry, I was going to find you the name of the current Johnston Press man. It's going to be too complicated. I'll pop it into the next videos. Yeah, he's now the Berwickshire Post's boss, and his name is also Johnston, for confusion and cover-up reasons. Yeah, completely anonymous, almost as anonymous as Smith, until you get to Lyndon B. Johnson, who sold his country by selling the central bank as soon as John F. Kennedy had been killed by the same people. Yeah, the Otto line that's in the joke about the man yesterday who is Ezra Pound. Yeah, E-S-R-A, and he becomes Ezrael for a laugh and entirely for profit through the Balfour and Churchill money streams, right into the Kaching project that is the Rothschilds world ownership project. Sorry, I'm taking a lot of time on this little movie clip.
To a job well done.
That it turned into something.
George, you moved the loot?
Less than perfect.
Disappointed.
So they have traitors within their movement, like World War I, World War II, and all of the issues at Nuremberg. Right through it, multilingual. Right through world history, right out of the Vatican, right out of Naples, right out of the Church of Rome. And as soon as the banks are invented, in come the Rothschilds, and in come the families that I've talked about with the name Seabag in their names. Yeah, Montefiore's. Yeah, that is the Mount of Fire joke that is the erupting volcanoes every time they launch the messianic human in place of the gods that created our world. And they think they're safe from that. Yet Pliny's brother, who was able to write about the first eruption in 79, no, the first eruption was when writing was invented, 2000 years before the fictitious Christ. Yeah, the rabbit sign is all about fascism, yeah, which is why Winston Churchill always uses it. That's the pukka joke, takes you into the Aegean. And when you look at the hats that all of the Quislings wear in world history, yeah, it is the red fez, yeah, the Phrygian hat joke. Yeah, and in Glasgow, when we're launching the Empire celebrations, the same year that the stammering king made the speech about having to take us to war, they were wearing the black and yellow fezzes, the Phrygian hats, in Ibrox Stadium. Right then. So, it's a very brief trailer. It lasts 1 minute and 28 seconds. Yeah, she's fucked off to Canada, like John Cleese has houses all over America, and he is a joke about the Klein Abbey, yeah, the Cluny Abbey in southern France, right next door to the Côte d'Azur, where Beaverbrook invited Churchill, yeah, to his elite home, the Villa Cappadocia, when it was Churchill's 50th wedding anniversary, and all of them have massive art galleries. Churchill has a house called Blenheim, which is the biggest treasure trove that was ever awarded anyone, because it's for the sectarian violence in the Orange Wars all across. That's the Battle of Blenheim and the launch of the Holy Wars, yeah, that are the likes of the 30 Years' War. Yeah, I've not looked yet at the circumstances behind the Hundred Years' War, but the usual suspects will be in it. Right then. So, she's back in Canada, and we have Mark Carney here now, former Bank of Canada man, who sponsored the Hoik Sivens and the Hoik joke that is all over the Walter Scott Club and the singing of that horrible song. Yeah, as they dance around in their trews as former heads of the Borders Council and as thieves and murderous people, yeah, in all of the corporate crashes that Lord Sanderson of Bowden launches and the scams that he launches all across the EU, which is created entirely so that people like him can thrive for profit, like the Cosmo character that is in the final scenes of the stammering speech film. You should watch it again. I might be able to find it and play it to you, yeah, with the explicit lyrics, yeah, because it is shameful that they are allowed to joke about the death of 60 to 80 million people in a premeditated contract that gives them the right to brutalize the world. All of the innocent bystanders are taken to places like Dresden and Churchill after they have firebombed that and created the route out of the war treasures are already out of it, yeah, and they then flattened the pavements and got rid of all of the innocent bystanders by firebombing it using Bomber Harris, the H-ARIAN joke. Yeah, it is relentless. Right then. It's only 1 minute 28 seconds. And that is likely to be a fiat in the background, because that is the fiat currency joke that even the Kiwis laugh at when they come on their rugby tours. They lie on top of the fiat currency joke and they have a huge laugh at that. That's the winger that is actually a Maori. Yeah, they are prepared to sell themselves and their countries, yeah, several times in the case of New Zealand. It is tragic. None of them will rise up and understand their history and all of the jokes about Holofernes and the things that they wear on their chest. My wife was given a Fern icon. She's taken it from my home. Yeah, she understands all of these jokes. And in that list, I showed you the music that I played at my wedding. I Never Give Up, and she knows it. I met her walking the streets of Kelso yesterday. She's looking lovely, like a blonde bimbo, yeah, like the people that were killed in the JFK regime, because they tried to support that honest president with all of their love and all of the fruits of their loins. That's Marilyn Monroe killed by our friends in this system. Okay? My wife looked really lovely, and strangely, she smiled at me as if she might nervously be watching these videos.
So they turned to a lawyer named
Archie Leech.
Leech.
George is going to tell him what the diamonds.
With Wanda as the.
So, Archie Leech, Archelaus, the de-lousing, shaved their heads and chucked them in the fucking fire pans, PISO joke, mentioned in Numbers, and you get the 32,000 virgins to despoil and to take their hymen wroths out for the one true God. Right then, we must be approaching the end. Oh, we're 43 seconds in. He's got a text behind the lawyer's desk, yeah, that he's likely to despoil her on, yeah, because she does not give anything about who she gives her sexual favours to as long as their cash is in it and their goldfish is stuffed up her major asset, which is her acrid vagina, because in the royal scandals, all of them get syphilis. That's the blue blood joke that they share in the arms to South Africa joke, when the man in the Out of Africa film gets syphilis. It's all a parody for the war crimes of the world leaders. And she's just a minor character in the House of Lords. So why should the world care? Which is why they only get 1 minute and 28 seconds.
Wait.
What did you do?
Nothing. He's really hooked.
I thought you weren't jealous.
I'm not. I don't believe in jealousy. It's for the weak.
Come again.
Yeah, the stole. Yeah, iconic and pink for cancer, which is now scaring the shit out of them. I don't know whether or not Baroness Haden Guest has been the victim of an act of God. I would not be at all surprised. She's made her way out of the prominent scene, yeah, and she's somewhere in the havens, living it up with everybody that just gets to live in luxury. Yeah, in all of the scams about world leadership, and they die in their fucking beds. Yeah, after taking the world to war at every opportunity, and now every country in our world is bankrupted by them, and the ownership of the issuance of the central bank is now complete, which is why Mark Carney and the lumberjack joke is so vicious. Sorry, Borders Council, I'll get round to you in a few minutes. No, 1.28 minutes.
Right as you.
And that would be subject to the Julian and Gregorian calendar jokes that they also share. And 1.28 is not actually a decimal concept, because we still use 60 seconds per minute. Okay, and this one, I think, is also a Canadian.
Your little brother is over.
Don't call me stupid.
I'm really, really sorry. I apologise unreservedly.
Are you Thom?
So, that's kind of accurate, because that's the mafias looking after law enforcement globally, which is laughed at in the movies that are made about the devil's advocate. And in that list of previous videos I've just watched is the one about the theme music for The Devil's Advocate, which is an explicit joke about the brutalization of Vietnam for its ownership. Yeah, that's the Rolling Stones that is the laugh at the Christmas Easter egg being the stone in front of Jesus's tomb. And Jesus is INEOS, the BP subsidiary where they kill the black people, yeah, in the Lonmin riots in South Africa. And they suppress the Scottish working man, even if he's a chemistry postgraduate. They're really clever people, but these people, these sad bastards that run the world by media propaganda control and the Borders Council, are totally in their hands now, totally in a massive debt pool. All of the law courts are closing, and that's the irony. They are killing and stealing from their own children and their own children's prospects.
mentally deranged?
They're French Earl, Jim!
John Cleese.
Will you leave immediately, please?
Jim Lee Curtis.
He's in there.
Kevin Klein.
Put the other one up!
Michael Palin.
May I kiss you, Kate?
No, you...
Sarah, yeah, his crimes are massive, yet the Pythons are a massive secret society in America. Lady Gaga is launched, and what I played this morning is the Judas story, yet, and the paparazzi stories, yet, on the musical system, yet there is YouTube to manipulate and trivialize the minds of the whole world. Yeah, that's paparazzi totally controlled by people like Max Hastings. Yeah, big bosses get to fish the River Tweed, live in leafy London, live in Kensington, like the man Rifkind, and they tell you that Scotland is better off under this leadership team. All of them are massive globalised criminals, and that is in the war criminality sector, which is why the Law Society in Scotland are ever so nervous about this, because they know the laws on complicity in war crimes, and they've already been exposed as being complicit to the Trident scandals and all of the arms to Iraq and war crimes profiteering through Abraxa in the lead up to that campaign led by Tony Blair and George W. Bush, who are linked into the Dubai scandal with Michael Moore and the P&O empire. Right then, what shall we learn next? We're into the last 28 seconds.
A fish called Wanda.
The fish joke, you've got it. Sex on a Friday. Yeah? Friday is the goddess of beauty and love. Like all of the day names for it, none of it is related to Christianity. All of it is related to the ancient myths about the real gods, and I don't know how humans can accurately know what their names are, but at least in the old days, the real gods in the sky were the inspiration for all of the decent civilizations like Greece that emerged from that, if the stories are true. The sun flickered a wee bit there. Okay, right then. So this guy's allegedly is a socialist. He's blinded in the right eye. Yeah, and he's got the socialist weapons that mean that we have to put him down at the end of the campaign, yeah, as we desert all of our friends in the profiteering team, and then we begin to accuse them of being communists, and we kill them with automatic weapons everywhere. That is the Walter Scott Society, the Freemasons in Scotland, Robert Peel in London, and the massive cabals of fascists that drive us to war and then kill the ordinary people that participate in it. Sorry, just a couple of seconds to go now.
Oh dear.
That could be the Stone of Scone. The Scones also interlock with the Rothschilds, like the Catos. Yeah, in the Peter Sellers films about the gems in the mountains in Switzerland, yeah, near Innsbruck, where Hitler and the baby Jesus found no room at the inn jokes. And even his light is the Parisian statue, yeah, and the Parisian elements of these jokes are absolutely vicious, which is why I no longer talk to the man from the commune that worries all the time about the chemtrails menace. Yet they are traitors to the free world. They are bought into speaking up the menace of things like the Martian invasions. Yet, and all of it is a mind control tool from religion to science fiction that runs the world in fear. Think it's really, really funny. Right then. So, Johnston Press. This is where Miss Susan Windram worked. Yeah? This is Ashley Highfield's mission in life, is to get rid of the press in Britain, to get rid of localised reporting. Yeah? So, that may be a mistake, because we may not be able to accuse people of being sexual criminals in our region. Yeah, and get everybody under surveillance for surrogate motives like that when we're actually investigating why this company, which is a joke about the orchard, yeah, the original sin, Orchard Bray House, 30 Queensferry Road, J.K. Rowling's House of Shaws, yet all of the come to Crammond on the weekend with the Scottish fascists and the Miss Mackay at Kelso High School, who also lives in the Queensferry region on the Lothian coast with Archbishop O'Brien, none of them get brought to justice from stealing the prospects of our children from our children, and all of it is in the name of the illegitimate Queen. Yeah, and then you find that the net worth for Johnson Press PLC is -$314 million. And their assets are only $72 million. Yeah? Yeah? And all of it is a huge stitch up. And that's just one of six registrations. Johnson Press Ireland Limited. Yeah? The sectarian place where Hillsborough is. Yeah, and all of the news about ambulance drivers and sticking plasters and me saying the fuck word on the screen that Miss Windram was prepared to write about, she's buggered off. Yeah, a minor diversionary magazine now. Yeah, like, I forget what it is. The other computer tells the story. It's irrelevant. They are living a life in sin and crime to cover up the life in crime of Prince Charles and his family and all of law enforcement globally, because there is none. Okay, Johnson Press Ireland has a net worth of $23 million. It's doing okay. It's got the Dr. Kildare joke in it about the religious fraud that I exposed yesterday. Okay, Kildare, County Kildare, Ireland. Johnson Press Bond PLC, I've not yet looked at that, makes me spooked to think about what it might be. The links to the Flemings and the Bonds and all of the savings scandals that the corrupted banks in the Irish Anglo crashing sector, yeah, they use that all of the time. The Co-op Bank was solvent when I first exposed the Lloyds Verdi project to take it over. Now it is hopelessly consumed in the toxic debt pool that is the Lloyds toxic debt pool. Part of the religious fraud through the castral systems that we talked about that take you into the Ortario character. Yeah, and the Spanish and Portuguese links are all through John Cleese's career. Yeah, because he knows that religion is a fraud and the whole of the Python's outlet is a joke about that. The B-ARIAN joke, the life of Brian, huge belly laugh until one of them dies under 40 on the Christian cross. Always look on the bright side, guys. Johnston Press, Orchard Bray House, 8th floor. Ooh, this must be a massive Babylonian building. Orchard Bray House, 30 Queensferry, Edinburgh. It could be what they pretend are the Scottish Civil Service buildings. Yeah, in Leith, where Alex Nicol was accused of being a red light prostitute visitor, but has been forgiven for that since he appointed Tracy Logan, which he links you into the frauds in Aberdeen when I get into the other room. Johnson Press Funding Limited. This has no declaration of its net worth. 53 Manor Place. Yeah? The aristocratic linkage does not even have a postcode. Let's have a look at that one. Directors. Because when you look for directors in the Scottish Borders Council on their funding side, it's all about real estate empires in Aberdeen, like the Miss Thom and the Windram visits that I've got in that earlier video, which led her to her resignation very, very quickly. And Kevin Drummond, because of his association with the fascism and the killing of the returning troops and the communists, in inverted commas, that's the ordinary people. Yeah, in the Lonmin scandal, it was the ordinary black people in South Africa. Right then, So this is the directors at Johnston Press, 53 Manor Place, Edinburgh. The sun's kind of glowing a bit. It's Jordan's, yeah, with the tits, yeah, the massive money laundering company. They have 1 or 2 days of service. There is no blue line detectable for them. That's the thin blue line in the police joke. And the other fraudsters, they've got 3 laundering companies, Oswald's, the owl joke, of Edinburgh Limited. They are massive laundering criminals, and Jordan's interlocks with them. If we were to look at that, you would see that their one day business is coincident with the laundering frauds, and all of the corporate entities will be lined up and they will be dumped into the havens where John Cleese, Archie Leech, yeah, and all of those characters in that movie now live. And we've got a sinister mafia presence, Mr. Marco Luigi Ottimilio Chiappelli. Yeah, the Kai joke is the Cairo joke, and I think that that might be the alpha to omega joke. It's all about linguistics and cheating the people. Okay, so it's run by 2 directors now, and there's a Timothy John Bowdler. He's got more courage than all of the Border Council's financiers. The Borders Council last year in 2014 issued an 80-page report. Yeah, and the man that is the treasurer has no longer got a section on their website. The corrupted auditors that are in charge of them, yeah, are registered in Glasgow. The man that has been, there is no auditor, I think it's KPMG that audited them. There is no registration in the Glasgow region for KPMG or the man that does the auditing. All of it is a stitch up. And we've got a Johnston on the directory of this, which is quite unusual. Frederick Patrick Mayor Johnston. Yeah, he served between 1996 to 1998. We had terrible sectarian troubles in Ireland. All the decades right back to World War II. Yeah. All the decades right back to World War II. And there's a David Flint. Right then, sorry, that's a minor diversion. Let me take you, and I'll show you the names of the aristocrats on the Johnston Press power brokers that are 300 million in the red. It's interesting, yeah? There are 2 Johnstons on the director listings. There are no Windrams, there are no Prince Charles, but believe you me, they will be tied into Rupert Murdoch and world ownership, and they are just slaves to the system. And even the religious jokes. Okay, now that I should not have clicked on directors there before I clicked on the company, because that will get me an endless list of every newspaper in our... Oh no, it doesn't. Okay, so we've got a McCall, but not like the McCalls of Monaco. Slightly different spelling, and I've explained that to you in the past. We've got a Camilla and a Rhodes person. Yeah, all the big names. There's a Highfield, Mr. Ashley Gilroy Mark Highfield. Ashley is officially the boss. It's him. Yeah, brought into the system when I became a fraud researcher, immediately appears like Susan Windram as one of my Facebook, one of my LinkedIn friends. And the LinkedIn editor is totally corrupted. He will not let you tell the truth unless it's propaganda about what these people are releasing. Merrill's. Yeah, my students now in Las Vegas. Oh, and the wood jokes. Yeah, and there's the Frederick Patrick Mayor Johnston. And we've got Patterson's and Murray's in Scotland. That's quite sinister. Henry Charles Marriott Johnston, the big hotel chain. Ah, never occurred to me before. And the Fries from the Blackadder team. that play Butcher Haig. There's our Italian connection to the Mafia. There's the connection to Halle's and the Hell joke. And the Coopers are on it. But at the bottom, you get Miss Martina Ann King. That could be Mervyn's Mrs. or his daughter. She's a maiden, look. That means nothing. Sir Henry John Roche. Yeah, the pharma magnates. The Lord Gordon of Strathblane. Let me quickly take you into the other room. I could play you a little snippet of the video. Let me show you how to find the video on Miss Windram's demise and her replacement at the Southern Reporter, since they defrauded me and convicted me as a violent criminal and got me attacked on the streets of my hometown, which I'm trying to save. Yeah, and all of them. Miss Thom is particularly villainous, yet she was the lawyer for the Borders Council until the year I arrived in Britain. She ran her divorce company from the streets of Kelso. Yeah, she runs the care home scandals. Yeah, she's a director on some of the corrupted charities like Dr. Moody, who lives in my scheme and retired as a profiteer from healthcare in his late 40s. Yeah, he's a nice guy. And the week that I announced about the treason and all of the horrible blood cancers that happened in the Rothschilds, he just happened to walk past my window same day with a little diagnostic bag and a sample. I feel sorry for him because they're intrinsically decent people. His wife is really nice. She chats to me all of the time, but they're embroiled deeply in all of the frauds that blight our country. That's my neighbours. Yet there are no holds barred now. Dr. Fingland has no pictures on the internet. He's the one who tried to have me sectioned. Yet he trained as a policeman before he trained as a medic, and the medical administrator now lives in that house across the road, and they like me. They're from the Lothians, yeah, and all of it is a ruthless cabal that is led by kings and queens and murderous emperors since the whole of the shenanigans was written, yeah, and that is 2,000 years ago when Vesuvius first erupted. Let me take you next door before my batteries run out. And Dr. Fingland lives right next door to one of the most corrupted locals of all, that is Alistair Hutton, runs the military tattoo in Las Vegas, or did before I came on the crime scene, yet makes the Christmas plea about the false Christmas from the Church of Scotland. And when we get to Remembrance Sunday, he's got soldiers in there talking up the violence in other people's countries. Right then, I'm not going to show you this password. I did not realise that Susan Windram had packed up until this morning. Yeah, and Kev Drummond has packed up, and they're explicitly mentioned in that. So this is the Borders Council. There's the 80 page account document. Scottish Borders Council statement of accounts for the year to 31st March 2014. 80 fucking pages of it. They're in a massive toxic debt pool. There is no comment on the management of that. The KP man in Glasgow as the auditor. Let me see what I've said about that. Tracy Logan and the Parker character reveal all of the secrets about their corporate remuneration. They might now, because of my campaign, be victims of the pay freeze. She doubled her salary when she got the job that I applied for, and Alec Nicol, yeah, has been forgiven his crimes in the red light district in Leith because they appointed her, and she's able to go to the chief executive meetings in the city of Aberdeen to find out how they can further steal from our world's democracy. Yeah, it's as big as that now. That's Aberdeen, where the Christian Bible was first printed in English in Scotland, and they had the earthquake in Nairn. Okay, the KP man in Glesky is undetectable as the auditor on all of the business registers, and the social landlords get 12 million. Yeah, that's the people that I sent in my Freedom of Information request to find out who were the fat bastards who get to take over the publicly owned care homes, the publicly owned rental houses all over the Borders region. And now they're able, in the massive toxic debt pool, to get bungs from the people that run this out of Aberdeen to bolster their morale as fraudsters. Yeah, the treasurer no longer appears on the web page, and the directors and secretaries on company check are institutions. Colouring book version here. Yeah. And this is the street address of their published output. And look at the buildings. It's the Walter Scotty places, and they are now the fucking privately owned care homes. Yeah. And the fishery management up near Melrose, that's run by a Kiwi that used to be a senior lecturer at Otago University. Yeah, it is pathetic. Yeah, they're looking at the lives of the species that are the parasites of the salmon, and they publish, they spend thousands of hours researching the minor issues about our natural wildlife. And the panda in Edinburgh, in Salmon's government regime, costs 70,000 in its food budget per annum to have a laugh at the Scottish citizens who have to live in poverty without a fucking pay rise for 7 years. Let me just, because you cannot download anything of this. Scottish Borders Statement of Accounts from 31st March 2014. Audited Statement of Accounts. Yeah, I tried to copy it. None of the images come across. All of it is an SS operation. Mysterious Treasurer's Minutes. Yeah, this is the Statement of Accounts. And if we wanted to, I could download it again to show you the fine details. It's 80 pages long. There is no summary that says this is what your toxic debt pool currently is, because they are subsidiarised, the ownership of it, to institutions. Yeah, and they're in Aberdeen, or they're all over Scotland, and they are now the owners of what were the public assets, and they're privatised, but we're not allowed to know the participant individuals, which is why my Freedom of Information request was refused. Let me see if there are any images. Oh yeah, Statement of Accounts. Yeah, this is, you can find it if you want. Take you a long, long time to read it, but it does not tell the truth about the toxic debt pool or any of the management issues of that, or who's in charge. Right then, so this is who's in charge. So company check institutions are not director IDs. There's the Scottish Borders Council, TD6 OSA, which is St Boswell's. When you look that up, it is really sinister, because you get the money laundering companies and all of the massive frauds running right next to the cricket club with the icon to the Lord's cricket ground, that are run by the Rangers player McKinnon. Yeah, and the Rangers player McKinnon died this year before I even discovered this. Right then, and you've got all, you've got a list, a massive list of corporate entities. Scottish Borders Council, directors for sole traders. So those four directors are not people with birth dates. They're fucking companies registered in Aberdeen, where the cabal of chief executives, and Tracy Logan used to work on BA Systems Limited, it used to openly declare that on her LinkedIn webpage, but now all of it has been taken down. Sole traders, 27, all of them have been removed from the company records. 1 to 10 of 27 non-limited company results. If they were limited companies, they could just live with the corporate crash and they would not have a cumulative debt pool. But because that would
to satisfy the greedy auditors who work for the greedy global financial institutions who continue with the massive asset stripping through the toxic debt system, and all of the funding for society disappears as a consequence. Four directors, yeah, here they are, and you've got four directorial registrations for the same postcode, for the same council, in the same address. Why would you do that? Yeah, unless you were defrauding it, and unless you were declaring something that was changed, or you were declaring that the composition of the boardroom, as people get elected, yeah, the elected people have no say in the running of the corporate side. Yeah, they cannot change anything. Like John Lamont, MSP, says, we're only MSPs. We cannot change anything in Scotland. And this is the subsidiary below that level, okay? Yeah, so when you click on directors, you do not find directors, you find this. Directors 4, Sole Traders 27. You've just seen all of those have been written out of the transcript. And there is short name for this director is... One of the four is Scottish Borders Council, year of birth unknown, director ID 919347307. If you can remember that, you're a better man than me, but let's have a look. Oh, sorry, that's gender bias. You're a better person than me. Second one of the four, 915694297. It's different. Yeah, but it's still the fucking council headquarters, Newtown St. Boswells, Melrose, Scotland, TD6, OSA. It's not actually Melrose, it's in St. Boswells, but maybe because of the laundering crimes, when you hit St. Boswells, you get horrific laundering crimes that take you into the Miller Homes empire, and all of the homes contracts, and all of the real estate scams. When we came back from New Zealand, there were massive homes built in the bubble that had just been burst, and people could not afford to buy them because their fucking pay has been frozen, yeah, and their children are workless, and all of it is total chaos, as the money lenders that Jesus warned us about taught us about. So that's a different corporate entity because it's got a different director ID, still the council at Newton St. Boswells, with no humans responsible for anything it does. There's the next one, director number 919358571. Okay, current appointment scanned 6 months as Scottish Borders supports LLP. Ah, I did not look at that one. Did not notice that. Let's see what the other one is. Scottish Borders so they've flitted into a new power base and they've shared the toxic debt pool with that. Scottish Borders supports LLP. I'll have a little look at that later. Year of birth unknown. The fourth of the four is, oh, it's got money at the bank. Yeah, it's Tweedside NHT 2011 LLP. Yeah, the year that my wife divorced me and Miss Thom became available. That's the news story. My wife actually left my home in June 2014. They now know that everyone's prepared to reveal that, except the members of the Scott family and all the sad bastards that take the trickle down in this region. Many of the homes in my streets now are being emptied because they know that what they've done is to try and obstruct the exposure of these massive crimes against the people. And the one that recently sold the house and moved on is a worker, a volunteer at the Citizens Advice Bureau, who know nothing about law enforcement, which is why Miss Thom's role in this whole story is so sinister. She's mentioned in the Susan Windram video, and all of the Thoms who have been provosts of Melrose, and all of the people
that are linked into the Windrums of Galashiels. They are quite ashamed now of what they've done, but not Miss Thom. She boldly and brilliantly carries on with the campaign to dismember me as part of the New World Order and the Canadian Power Base, who are doing okay. Yeah, they are now running our central bank, Mark Carney. Okay, so Scottish Borders Council number 4 holds one appointment at one active companies, has resigned from zero companies, held zero appointments at zero dissolved companies. The longest current appointment spans 3 years and 11 months at Tweedside NHT 2011. So 3 years from that takes you to 2008, when the fucking banks were crashed and the Icelandic banks were their preferred funders. Like Sally Magnuson's pension. The combined cash at bank value for all businesses, yeah, holds a current appointment equals 213,000, with a combined total current assets value at 57,000 and total current liabilities of 125,000. Ooh, so they're not insolvent after all. Year of birth unknown. Council headquarters, Melrose, Scotland, TD6 OSA. There's Tweedside NHT 2011 LLP. Yeah, and when you look it up, it lives at registered address 12 to 16 Albion Place, Aberdeen, AB101PA. That's where Salmond comes from, and that's where John Wood runs the roost in the city, runs Ineos, the inscription on Jesus' cross, which means Jesus. Yeah, and Ineos is the ordinary working man who never gets a fucking pay rise, even in the corporate sector, even if you have a PhD in chemistry, or even if you're the corporate doctor that works in their corridors. Yeah. Tweedside NHT 2011 fly by night into Aberdeen, where all of the chief executives who are unelected run the profiteering, like Tracy Logan. Unfit for work for several months, yet when I last inquired, she now attends the Catholic celebrations with the man Michael Ancrum. Yeah, he's responsible for some of the biggest military institutions in the constituencies in the deep south of England before he was invited into the House of Lords, and is on the Conservative Clubs UK. That's the Tory club where the price of the beer in the Borders is cheaper, and Thom Weatherston, the ordinary working man from Kelso, has joined his cabal, because it's the only way now you can be elected. So that's Sir John Wood. Yeah, I've got neighbours who are admirers of him, and they used to work at the school that has been taken over by the corporate world, that is the university up there where I've been refused jobs at interviews. Yeah, and that's in the pharmacy school, and the people that interview me are the chief pharmacists for Scotland. That's Bill Scott, with a Scott name. Yet the Scots in my scheme, even although I used to join them and they are family friends. Thank you to Kathleen for showing signs of a conscience. Yet when I visited Kathleen when we came back from New Zealand, they made it plain to me that I was under surveillance. Her husband, yeah, I used to admire and love her daughter, yeah, who works in one of the big banks now, yeah, and is married to a Hague. Can you see how the cabals and the allegiance to the ancient corrupted families that run our world, and the persecution of the non-existent Jesus with the John Wood joke, yeah, with Jesus being the name for his company that deserts the working man? Can you see how serious it is? And Fish Called Wanda's trailer is only 1 minute and 30 seconds long. This is, oh, have we got to the bottom? Yeah, we have. Well, that's the sad story about the corporate ownership and the individuals who were never born,
who are in charge of our local council, and they get all of that audited by KPMG, who are in charge of all of the corrupted institutions all around the world with the other three big auditors. That is Deloitte's, PricewaterhouseCoopers, where my mate Graham Hogg used to work. Yet my mate Graham Hogg now has a conscience. He's bought a revolutionary red car and he's given up his place in the elite PricewaterhouseCoopers fishing syndicate. Yeah, that the local men work in, yeah, and they shoot the doves, and they are jokes about being people from the place called Yetim. Yeah, that is an icon for, yeah, the residencies, yeah, the Watson people that live there, the people that work in the massive asset stripping of Africa, that are the Watson people, with homes in New Zealand, in Auckland. Yeah, it is a massive globalised cabal of thieves and really clever people, and the Watson people have degrees and postgraduate degrees in breweries like the Guinness Empire and the McGuinness crimes and treason all across sectarian Ireland. Scottish Futures Trust Limited, Tweedside, NHT 2011 LLP. That's the institution that is the director at the Borders Council, is just a director at the Scottish Futures Trust Limited. Registered. Yeah, and this is the Braveheart joke about the little gift that his girlfriend, who gets her throat cut by the English Better Off Together people in the Red Cross uniform, yeah, that brutalises the Holy Lands for thousands of years under the orders of the Church of Rome. Yeah, they are registered at 11 to 15 Thistle Street. Yeah, that's what the Scottish citizens get, the prickly little plan and the pledge of love for life from their wives, who get their throat cuts after they've been shagged on the first night of their wedding. Yeah, by the local English landlord. Which is why I was so stunned to find the Ogilvies are part of that news item and the video I made on Miss Susan Windram, because they are tied in, of course, to the Prince's Trust. That's why the Catholic Church have sainted St. Ogilvy since I told you that story. That's all the bullshit of the Southern Reporter and Johnston's Press. And here's the funding mechanism for the corrupted toxic debt pool that consumes every one of Scotland's local councils. Tracy Logan doubled her salary as head of HR from 70,000 to 130,000 when Alec Nicol was forgiven for his red light district crimes in Leith. And the man Mitchell that used to talk to me is the man who's privileged enough to meet David Cameron in his recent visit to the Borders Council, yet a low-life council with nothing much to declare apart from the sins of its previous leaders, Deirdre Hutton and Alistair Hutton. Alistair is brave enough to stay in the public light, even in the fascist Walter Scott Club that appointed the Archbishop of Canterbury in World War I and the lead-up to the treasonous crimes of the British Royal